local breaking news. This is WYFF News 4 at 6 in high definition.
This is what rain did to a business plaza in western North Carolina. Part of the parking lot is gone, thanks to the recent heavy rainfall. Welcome to a rainy July 4th with relentless thunderstorms throughout our area.
Relentless is right. Chief Meteorologist John Sesswich is watching again. John, we need some independence from the soup, right?
Yeah.
Boy, no kidding. I tell you, this is just ridiculous, Michael and Carolyn. It's a very dangerous situation, getting reports where they're trying to respond to flooding problems in Buncombe County, and the authorities are having a tough time even getting all these. They're getting so many calls, they can't get to all these places. And the flash flood warning still continues for you folks in central Buncombe County. I'll talk more about that in just a second. Then we had some nasty thunderstorms that originated through McCormick, and Abbeville, Anderson, Pickens, and now beginning to slide into the southern and central part of Transylvania County. These thunderstorms right now are not severe, but they're producing a lot of lightning, extremely heavy rainfall, 1 to 2 inches per hour. We've been talking about this all week long. This is deep tropical moisture, and most of us saw 1 to 3 inches of rain today. Expect another 1 to 3 inches of rain on average overnight tonight through tomorrow. And there is the warning. The flash flood warning continues for you folks, including downtown Asheville, for central Buncombe County until 9:30 this evening. We'll talk more about this storm system in detail a little bit later on. Now back to you, Michael and Carol.
We'll be right here, John. Thanks for that. Now to those flooded homes and the washed out roads.
That's just some of what the heavy rainfall has done to the mountains. Tonight, rising water levels across western North Carolina remain a concern. News 4's Parul Joshi talked to some people who say their homes can't take much more.
This is what's left of part of a parking lot off Highway 213 just outside Mars Hill, thanks to the rain. Crews say a culvert collapsed and the heavy waters eroded the ground. The rainfall also meant rising water levels at the French Broad River Basin. Emergency management kept a close eye on the river Thursday, saying the levels were about a foot and a half above the flood stage of 8 feet. As the water roared, Charles McDevitt said Wednesday's rain was the worst he remembers.
I took my wife and went right around the side of the house right there and hit the hill. And went right upside that hill and put her up there in the camper.
McDevitt says the water from the creek flowed over this barrier.
It come right through this right here. It come, you can see where it beat. If you'll look all the way to the other side of the house yonder, it beat that out.
After tearing up the flower beds, the water eventually made its way under his house, even inside the closed garage. This stain on the refrigerator shows just how high the water got. Though McDevitt says he has a lot to clean up, he's grateful.
I'm just thankful to the good Lord that that it didn't get in the house or wash the house away or somebody get drowned.
That's Parul Joshi reporting for us tonight. Today, about 40 Red Cross volunteers and staff were in the area to make sure the people there were taken care of.
Here's some more fallout, this time in the upstate. Many of you were dealing with power outages this morning in and around Greenville. Duke Energy's website reported close to 3,300 out before noon today, and a lot of you on the roads noticed a lot of the traffic lights went dark too. Greenville police say the outages were weather related, and they did affect the signal lights on Lawrence Road near the zoo all the way to Woodruff Road. The lights were also down on Pleasantburg Drive near Antrim Drive down to East Ferris Road. This reminder tonight, and it's important, when the lights go down like that, police say you should treat the intersection as a four-way stop. The power was back on before 1 o'clock.
A Greenville County strip club is back open tonight after the bomb squad was called this morning. Platinum Plus off I-385 was evacuated after officials say an employee cleaning the parking lot found a suspicious device around 9 in the morning. Fire officials and deputies responded and brought a bomb robot. Officials wouldn't let us see the device, but they described it as a fire extinguisher made to look like a bomb.
It had a fuse in the top, an igniter, some wiring, and like a timer taped to it.
There was no note and no one was injured. The bomb squad did detonate the device. We're told it will likely be sent to SLED for further investigation. Officials are calling this a bad prank. Anyone with information is asked to call Crime Stoppers. The number, 23-CRIME.
You don't see this every day. It looked like an explosion of seatbelts on Batesville Road in Greenville County today. Take a look for yourself. Seatbelt parts and debris were strewn all over the road. Buckles, belts, tissue paper. In fact, it was enough for the Department of Transportation to use a dump truck to get in there and clean up the mess. We're still not sure tonight how all this debris ended up in this particular place. Viewers have said they saw the parts spill out, though, of a sanitation truck. Okay, may not look like the best night for fireworks, but the folks at the Wells Fargo Red, White, and Blue Festival in Greenville say those fireworks are going to fill the skies tonight no matter what.
Especially after last year's fireworks fizzle. News 4's Tim Waller with how officials in downtown Greenville are hoping to prevent another finale fizzle.
With every fireworks show comes a grand finale. But last year,
you know, we're sorry.
It was a fizzle.
There could be no one more disappointed than the city and all the volunteers and our sponsors.
This 4th of July, there is John Edwards' crew.
This is a lot more reliable in this kind of weather.
And they're here to make a lot of noise.
You'll have three levels of chaos going on, but it's controlled chaos, so it's fun.
Edward says the rain is a concern, which is why they come to these events prepared.
Looks like a trash bag, but it's a specialized plastic that is fire retardant. It will not melt and it will not burn.
They also keep the fireworks dry in case the skies open up at go time.
First and foremost, if it gets too wet, it won't shoot at all.
But he's worked in rainy conditions before and has no doubt all 500 of these fireworks will deploy, dazzling the crowds.
That finale, the last shell shoots and you hear the crowd.
He says that's when you know you're a hit.
It'll almost bring a tear to your eyes, like, yeah, you know, it was successful and they're happy.
So stay tuned, bring the rain gear. And by the way, that's Tim Waller tonight. Wells Fargo Red, White, and Blue is set to explode, so to speak, around 9:45 tonight. Now, earlier, we need to tell you this. We reported that Greer's fireworks show was to happen tonight, but now we understand the city has already held its fireworks display.
From Red, White, and Blue to Red, White, and Boom. That's Spartanburg's big star-spangled celebration. News 4's Mike McCormick with a look at Spartanburg's celebration for tonight.
Red, White, and Boom just got underway at 6 o'clock here in Barnett Park in downtown Spartanburg. You can see all the places to get food. Check out the bag of cotton candy that I got when we got out here just a little while ago. We've seen plenty of people getting all sorts of food and drinks and then going over there and taking a seat, getting ready for all the entertainment they've got planned tonight. You've got patriotic music from the Spartanburg Community Band. For the first time, they're doing a presentation on the Declaration of Independence. And for the first time in 4 years, they've got a nationally known band taking the stage at around 8:15. That is country music star Brett Eldridge. He's expected to play until about 9:30. And of course, the main event comes at 9:40, and that is the fireworks. This is a rain or shine event, so don't let the weather scare you away from Barnett Park here in downtown Spartanburg. It'll cost you $5 to get in. Mike McCormick, WYFF News 4 in Spartanburg.